Hey guys, Rugger Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 and Atletico Madrid career mode. I keep almost mixing it up with the Westerlo career mode. I keep almost saying it. I don't know why. Hopefully that's not gonna be a continuous thing during the whole career mode. Anywho, this is the secondary career mode, aka the Atletico Madrid career mode. In the last episode, I picked up I absolutely demolished my opponents. I beat Sevilla 7-0 in the league, and I beat Oviedo 7-0 in the Copa del Rey. So, yeah, I did a bit of damage defensively.
Describe the action for you.
Which led me to question whether someone had reset the thing or something. Because I could not figure out why, for the life of me, I could not figure out why it was
difficult. Parties keep themselves there.
Really?
Might just get a little nervous, but full credit to them for what they've achieved so far.
Well, this is always the great moment. The ball's on the centre spot, and we're all ready to go.
So it takes me more than two games to score 14 goals.
Miranda in central defence. Koke starts alongside Saul in the middle of the park. Antoine Griezmann plays together with Angel.
But, lo and behold, that was indeed what happened.
They lead the league in that respect.
They are the entertainers in this division.
We'll see if that run continues here against Malaga.
For you on the Malaga team.
Now, in both of those games I scored in the first 5 minutes, I don't think I'm not going to have any. Best I could do is probably go.
Well, the building's settling here, working away.
And Malaga don't beat me to it.
I had a real
go. Put him under pressure. Luckily, I
the finishing touch.
Made sure their shot was not anywhere near my goal. Without using the corner. Griezmann. Correa's going to score! It's going to go down to the 11th minute, but Correa has opened the score.
The supporters are going crazy. It's a terrific moment for the team. That goal for Atletico.
Griezmann's initial shot was saved, but it was put straight onto the plate of Correa, and he is hungry.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
I mean, you can't argue with form. And that's just not something you can do.
Keeping the ball. Here comes the challenge. There'll be a throw now after the tackle.
Correa's on unbelievable form.
On the attack here. They've coped with it well defensively. Griezmann.
Oh, Griezmann makes the Malaga defender looks stupid. Goes for goal. This comes across. Yeah, again. This keeper has a very bad head habit. He needs to cut that shit out.
That's very good defending. And the player.
Yeah, forced him to give me that throw. Anderson. Whips it in. Oh, the defender cleared it before Griezmann could get anything on it to send it goal. Oh, wise. Goal. Direction, I should say. One friend.
Played into the middle.
Whips in. Goalkeeper. Yeah, I was about to say the keeper will probably get there first. And Griezmann fouled him. Brilliant. Alright, there it's offside. It's not showing me anything about offside decision. We normally do that. So I'm going to assume when the keeper fell down, he fell down because of Griezmann. Going in for the header. I mean, that could happen to any striker.
It's a daunting prospect for the visitors, isn't it? They've got to defend well here, that's for sure.
Gone on one possession back.
Ah! Great tackle. from the mag of the Finn brother and Correa to get the ball and prevent penalty.
Camacho.
Now one of those tackles that you have to get spot on or
to switch the play.
There will be a spot kick in the vicinity.
Tackle goes in. Into the attacking third. He's gonna try his luck. Good stop by the goalkeeper.
I don't know what Malaga were trying to do there, but it failed miserably.
For Atletico Madrid, they do have the lead. Saw. They have shown moments of promise.
Make a better run.
In front of goal,
okay, I guess I'm going all on my own here. Saul, 2-0.
And they do lead now by two.
Just before the halftime and break.
So,
doubles my advantage in this game.
To admire the way he placed the ball into the bottom corner of the net.
But the goalkeeper was in a decent position, but he was helpless to...
I wanted someone to make a supporting run so I could pass it to him. But Correa just didn't seem interested, so Saul went on his own. And he gets the goal. Third goal of the season.
Restarting.
Young Spaniard.
Now Diego Llorente. Rosales. Duda. Looked very good indeed, but the...
Gives me a nice cushion heading into
the, shows three
the second half.
That's a free kick award.
Oh, come on. Slightly missed time.
To do Alan with that slide
yeah,
challenge.
Not even a yellow card.
Well, it was badly timed. He didn't get the ball, and he knows he's committed a foul there.
I grazed him at best, and he fell to his
best. Oh, he's good at cutting those passes.
Well, that's half time. 2-0 is the score at the halfway mark. They're pushing on again, Atletico Madrid, towards yet another success. They lead at the break. So it is time now for the start of the second half.
Now let's finish Malaga off in the second half.
And in he goes with the tackle, Diego Godin.
There's Saul.
Onto the attack now. And here comes the counter-attack.
Griezmann!
Offside called, and we can see again now.
Shook the bar, but that's
yeah, I think it was. And in the end, not a difficult one, because there was a couple of yards in it, I think.
Hey,
Griezmann.
Gokwin, Gokwin's there, and here's Griezmann. Loses it way too easily.
Here comes the challenge.
On Antoine. For fuck's sake, man.
Shot's on here. The shot gets blocked. Camacho.
All they're doing is passing the motherfucking ball around. Really annoying.
Atletico Madrid winning.
I understand that's part of the game, but they're not even. They weren't even making any progress.
Could be dangerous. Gonna try it!
Oh, Koke, I thought he had scored mid three. Oh, sorry, it was Saul. In the excitement, my two central midfielders both mixed up. Oh well, no harm, no foul. Miranda!
Hands on. Atletico Madrid now. This could be a chance.
Great ball to Correa. 3-0, top corner. And it's game over. Malaga are beaten.
Well, scoring in any game is worthy of celebration. When you get two, it is special.
Great.
And he is feeling that special delight at the moment.
Ball into it.
Let's have another peek at that goal.
Slot it home. Like. Absolute.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead. Camacho. It's out for throw for Atletico Madrid. Well, he's threaded the pass through Nick.
Griezmann!
Great stop.
Carrasco! I'm going to preempt it now. This might be too early. The ball has to go out.
Stopped by the goalkeeper.
The same play for another minute.
Madrid have a substitution in mind.
Okay. Now the ball needs to go out.
And that will be a goal kick.
I overhit that, but it was kind of intentional.
Takes his leave
so
of the game.
I can get that kind of. And that way, they've both.
Of this caliber.
I'm trying to balance their men.
Could play on the wing and track back as well. He's got a good work ethic.
I don't know what's showing on black. Okay.
Just over a quarter of an hour left on my watch.
He's not going anywhere.
Correa. Real threat from Atletico Madrid in these positions. They cope with it well defensively.
Here is guy Tang, and he scores!
Well, how long's he been on?
He's just on the pitch, and guy Tang makes it 4-0.
With a wonderful goal.
For Atletico Madrid, a big success this, and by a pretty decent margin, it looks like.
I think that's the first goal guy Tang or Carrasco scored.
Playing over and over again, isn't it?
Sure, but it's a very good goal. Well, it's definitely his first this season. I'll have to check. I don't think Carrasco has.
4-0.
I think that is the first goal we've gotten from either of them.
This is how they love to play on the break. He's got his shot off now. Still a chance in there on the goalkeeper. By no means a formality this match for Atletico Madrid, but they've had it under reasonable control.
Did not sit well with Carrasco.
Performance by them, and the outcome, I think, although still in some doubt, is going to favour their victory. Defender to it first. Well, that will mean a corner coming up now. And 5 minutes remaining. Shots on here.
Luis! Oh, hit Miranda and went out! That may have gone in. If Miranda hadn't gotten his stupid. Oh, he's offside anyway. But if he hadn't gotten in the way, it might have gone in. It might have still gone out as offside.
Charles.
Which has been fucking controlling Miranda. Now I'm right at the defence.
Here's a chance to attack.
There we go. Gives Miranda a chance to get back into position. I'm trying to fuck him.
It'll be 4 minutes. It is going to be a win for Atletico Madrid, and the supporters are just cheering them to the final whistle.
Yeah, often you can relax and just enjoy the moment, but the team's in charge, and so are the fans.
I wasn't going to get that, which is why I put on the brakes. This will get to.
That
time again! Oh, I didn't hit it hard enough.
And keeps the ball in his grasp.
I kind of like lightly tapped it for some reason. I know. Oh, I completely messed up. That should have been. That might have been the chance to get that two goal. off the
look
bench.
At that scoreline.
He'll have to settle for
what we've seen in the shape of the game as well. Very one-sided.
Well, the first whistle, they were on top and it never altered for the entire.
I thought for a second there, that guy was hobbling off.
It is another home win.
Didn't see anything about an injury. I hope that's not the case.
La Liga. Atletico Madrid.
I only committed that one foul before I grazed that guy in two. The first half of greasing. Other than that, I didn't
Deportivo La Coruña two. Valencia.
If anyone was injured, it's not my fault.
Let's take a look at what those results mean to the league table. At the top of the table remain Atletico Madrid with 27 points. In second, Villarreal with 22 points. In third, climbing the table, Barcelona with 19 points. In fourth and falling are Real Sociedad with 17 points. In fifth, moving down, are Espanyol with 17 points. In sixth, rising up the table, are Valencia with 17 points. In seventh and falling are Real Madrid with 16 points. In eighth, moving down, are Malaga with 15 points. Bottom of the table, Osasuna with 4 points. And then reading up the table, second bottom, Real Betis with 5 points. Third bottom, Deportivo Alves with 6 points. Fourth bottom, Deportivo La Coruña with 10 points. Fifth bottom, Pion with 10 points.
Take this opportunity to quit and find a different profession. Football ain't for you. Clearly. Is up next in the Champions League. As you can see, I've already set up the team for the next game. This will actually qualify me for the knockout stage of the Champions League. And it will win me the group. Well, it'll depend on what happens between Bayern and PSV, but it might win me the group. It's a possibility. I need Bayern not to win. If they win, I will have to win one more game. So let's just turn on the notifications for that game. And advance. What am I doing?
Well, the team's now facing their fourth match in this Champions Cup group stage. A lot of good football been played already, and let's see what match day four brings.
Yeah, you're looking for consistency, aren't you, in these group stages, and one or two teams have shown that already. I wonder if they can continue it here today.
Quite a few changes for Atletico Madrid. Andre Morera is the goalkeeper. That's with Thiago in the middle. In attack, Kevin Gamero.
Terrible attempt to get across to Fernandes.
Comes in with a tackle.
Gusto, apparently.
Here comes the cross. Goes for it with a fist.
Second game, he's going by his first.
But it's a big day. Could be a big day for the home team. They've got the chance already in this group to clinch their place in the knockout stages, Alan.
Ramiro! 1-0.
It's a great start for them. A wonderful goal.
9 minutes into the game.
Approach to this game.
We'll probably go down to the 10th minute goal. Works.
Well, this is what you call leading from the front. A strike from the skipper.
Yeah, he's popped up at a very good moment there.
And here is another angle on that goal.
Yeah.
that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here. Engels. Vieto attacking well here. The referee can manage this match and giving the foul, I think it's quite a good thing to do. It's a great moment in the match and worth another view. Gamero's goal.
Yeah, well, there might be a few fingers pointed at the keeper, but I don't think so. He's hitting so hard from that distance.
On the attack here. He's looking for the cross. He could do a better cross.
Kind of
like
on the same level as the foul I committed with Reitman in the first game of this episode.
Well, they're building steadily here, working away. And it will go into the middle now. Trying to cross it. And in the end, a bit of a waste, I think.
Go.
Attacking now.
Someone's in the box.
They cope with it well defensively.
Thiago! This is why they're not in the first team.
Into the attacking third. Oh, chance!
Oh, yes, it's gonna go in! It's 2-0!
They've got a firmer grip on the game now. They're two ahead.
Romero again. Banging himself a double. And putting Cruz under all sorts.
Very good build-up, Alan. Very good goal.
Well, the goalkeeper did his very best, but I think he might have regrets that he didn't get hold of that.
Good luck here, again.
Took a hefty deflection off of the Bruges defender. I don't know if that's going to go down as an own goal. It'll probably still go down as Romero's goal.
Restarting at 2-0.
Indeed it will.
Timmy Simons. Gamero tries the through pass.
Vieto. Oh, 3-0. Oh. Making it 3-0 instantly.
Nicely taken.
Certainly was. They seem to be heading for a comfortable lead.
Vieto.
It's given them a comfortable situation here. 3-0 as the game gets
4 minutes between the second goal and the third goal.
Vieto. Excellent play to lose his marker. And shoots! Good work by the goalkeeper.
Thiago is trying to eat the keeper by hitting a long shot, but was more prepared for
it. Away, and that's what you have to do. And it's out for a throw for Atletico Madrid. Vieto. Defender to it first. Simons. Makes a challenge here. Now they've got a chance in this part of the pitch. Simons, Thiago, crowd maybe expected a bit more, but it's two added minutes.
Henrique
looked very good indeed, but the move was broken.
Very well. Half time, 3-0 up.
His whistle, and it's 3-0 here at half time.
Comfortable gap to go into the second half with, and that's exactly what I wanted to see from Holland. PSV 0, Bayern Munich 0. They are fully capable of getting that the goal they need in the second half. But as things stand, not only am I going through, but I'm winning the group.
In now to the second half of their fourth match.
I mean, I don't care about winning.
To progress, and it's going to be an interesting matchup, this one.
It's a nice bonus to win the group.
Well, they're in a good position here. Lost his man. There goes the cross.
Kevin Gamero! Won this game. That'll be it. For the group stages of this competition, for this career mode, I'll be simming the other two games.
Yeah, he won't forget this day in a hurry. Top stuff from him.
As Romero makes it 4-0, I think that's his hat trick. Is that his hat trick? It is, isn't it? Vieto scored the air goal.
Turning out to be
Kevin Guerrero will be taking home the match ball. And we will definitely be taking home the 3 points.
Atletico Madrid now attacking dangerously. Got past him. And now the shot! Still on the attack, and they've got a corner. Well, this guy looks like he's the one the opposition having the most problems with.
Huh. You can see from the graphic how busy he's been.
All on the same side of the goal. That's an odd coincidence.
Some reward too.
The shot's on!
Averno! Kind of high. I put it kind of high.
Madrid throw. On to the attack now. Promising build up until that challenge. What we are going to bring soon to EA Sports is the La Liga fixture. Atletico Madrid, they'll be facing Real Sociedad away from home.
Well, when you look at the matches in the past between these two, it doesn't usually disappoint, and I don't think this one will either.
Attacking well here. And in goes the cross. He could do a better cross than that, I think. And it was easy to cope with. Well, he could be in.
Vieto. Being through on goal, can he make it 5? Yes, indeed, can. Lovely.
Corner of the net. Well, he's doubled up here with his second goal, and he took it
5-0.
Excellent style, just like the first one.
I mean, this is
losing count. It's 5-0.
Dominant performance, in my last episode standards.
And he gives it back to him. He's coming forward with some danger. Shots on here. He's tackled well. It was a good challenge. This led to a corner. And heads it towards goal.
So I'm pretty happy with myself. To be progressing, assuring my qualification into the knockout stage of the Champions League, and possibly winning the group in some style. I say possibly because
he's missed the target.
He's normally a better header of the ball.
There could still yet be a Bayern Munich goal to upset the balance. For lack of a better,
I see a substitute coming.
For term,
away team here. This could be a chance.
Romero, why didn't you hit that the first time? You didn't score for your fourth and the team's sixth because you took a touch. Sometimes long over. As a touch as necessary. In that case, it would have been better to hit it first time.
It's 82 minutes played now.
It was on play, and you practically said, nah, I'm good.
It's looking good, this move. There's the ball in.
Pedro is so fast, luckily. Defenders in my box don't need to be fast to clear the ball.
Good chunk of added time here. Well, 3 minutes.
After a subpar.
And here's the shot.
Cross, Gabby. Over.
Well, you can't knock him. He was in the right place at the right time. Just couldn't provide the finishing touch.
Ref, I think you can end this game now.
Just 1 minute left on the clock.
Yep, there's the full-time whistle. Oh, I am through to knockout stage of the Champions League. Let's see if I've won the group with 2 games to spare, or is it still up for grabs? Nope, I've won the group with 2 games to spare. There was no goals in the game between PSV and Bayern Munich.
Monaco,
this
one.
Group is
Juventus, 2.
Really Arsenal, easy.
3. Borussia Mönchengladbach, 2. Bayer Leverkusen, 4.
I might be going out on a limb and saying this, but yeah. It was really easy to qualify and win the group. Like, most times I don't win the group until after the 5th game, but I've won it before. In 4 games. I mean, Bayern are probably still gonna qualify unless they turn to Ratchet in the last 2 games in PSV or Bruges catch them. I mean, there is only 4 points between the 3 of them. Bayern are on 6 points. Okay. Now, Bayern are on 5 points. Okay. Yeah, they're on 5 points. My mistake. If they were on 6 points, I would still technically have won the group, but, you know, I wouldn't. They would still mathematically be able to catch me, but my goal difference is way superior. So, yeah, it's now a 3-team race for that second spot. Because first spot is going to Atletico Madrid. Ahead of a game against Real Sociedad in the league. And... ooh, Real Madrid! Oh, there is a second leg to the Oviedo game. Oh, I thought that was I thought we were in the round before that. Okay. Well, that game is completely fucking pointless. And this Bayern game is completely pointless. So, this Granada game and an Osasuna game will be the games you see. These 2 games are, like I said, completely fucking pointless. I mean, they're useful to PS. To Bayern and Oviedo, well, not so much Oviedo. Oviedo are 7-0 down. I mean, if I lose that tie against Oviedo, I will quit FIFA forever. That's just the way it is. Luckily, that won't happen. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.